But interesting, of course, we celebrate Indian science. But let me go across to my next guest for tonight. And he's an Indian scientist, a molecular biologist, Dr. Partho Sarothi Ray, who was freed today after 10 days in jail after angry protests globally by scientists and human rights activists. Dr. Ray was arrested because he took part in a protest against the forceful eviction of slum dwellers in West Bengal. He said today West Bengal is living in dark days and that he was targeted for speaking his mind. I spoke a short while earlier to Dr. Ray and I began by asking him, Dr. Ray, 10 days in jail, couldn't be further removed, really, from the world of a molecular biologist as a scientist. What was it like for you? And did you ever imagine when you sat that peaceful protest that you could, well, land up in jail for this?
See, in this country, people like Binayak Sen has been in jail. So I guess means you have to always be prepared for something like this. Means the experience was completely something I was not prepared for. But it has been an eye-opener.
An eye-opener, and perhaps something else which wasn't expected was a huge global response and the national response that came to your arrest. Ironically, of course, many have pointed out that why did this come under the regime of a chief minister who came into power just a year ago protesting against what she had termed a regime of repression. Your thoughts on this, Dr. Ray?
Not really, because we have seen that the situation in West Bengal has remained the same. This entire issue of eviction of slum dwellers, the new government came to power on the issue of eviction of farmers from the land in Singur and Nandigram. And when this new sequence of eviction started, starting off with Nonadanga, it showed that the situation had not changed. So although it has been a shock to many people, I think it was on expected lines.
Professor Ray, what do you see? We've seen a series of incidents and we've seen Mamata Banerjee has given an interview saying that we learn from our mistakes, that only the negative aspects are being highlighted. What were the positive aspects of what she has done in the state of West Bengal? What do you see this whole string of incidents as, including what happened to Professor Abhishek Mahapatra over a cartoon? What do you see as the most dangerous aspect of this?
I think the most dangerous aspect is the stifling of the democratic voice, stifling on people's rights of expression, right to assemble peacefully, right to take out rallies. The West Bengal has always been known for its democratic spirit, where people have been very conscious, they have been out on the streets protesting on issues. And this government has actually come to power based on people's protests, people's movements. And therefore, this is a very worrisome trend that people's movements, people's issues are being trampled upon.
Do you feel, when you talked about West Bengal's tradition of protest, do you feel that this your arrest has actually scared other people who protested with you are still in jail, even though you've been released?
Yeah, it is very much possible. This was possibly done to send a message to other potential protesters, potential people like me who are from the academia, who are from the intellectuals, that not to come out into the open in protest, not to criticize the government. This might have been just to send them a message.
Right. Professor Ray, just to ask, because this seems to have become all about very much focused against Mamata Banerjee, but given the current situation we've seen in around the country, do you think this is really just about one chief minister or one political party? Do you think that similar incidents have happened earlier under the left government? Do you think the worry really is about a larger suppression of voices of protest around the country?
Absolutely. I think that this is not the case of a one political party or one person as a chief minister. It's the issue of the entire country where neoliberal policies are being imposed on the people and people are being deprived of their lives and livelihoods. And whenever there are protests, it is being stifled. So this is a countrywide phenomenon and this is a manifestation of that what we are seeing in West Bengal.
Finally, of course, Professor Ray, if you had to give advice to the Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee, what would you say to her tonight?
Yeah, I would tell her that please go to Nonadanga. Please go and see the condition of the evicted slum dwellers over there who are lying in this open under the sun and the rain for the last 20 days. And I would request her to come and speak with people like me. Means people like me who have only the best interests of the people of West Bengal in their mind. People like my co-prisoners who are still languishing in prison. She should go and speak with them and then she would know that what is the real situation in West Bengal. And this would be honest criticisms which I think would help her and her government to, as she's telling, to learn from the mistakes.
Right, Professor Ray, thank you so much for speaking to us tonight. And of course, this comes in a day when Mamata Banerjee has been chosen as the only Indian politician amongst Time's 100 list of most influential people in the world.
Do you have the NDTV Profit app? All the markets, all the news and your own homemade, ready-made portfolio available there for you.
We will right now answer what you should sell, what you should buy when markets are down.
Download at ndtvprofit.com/apps. Get the best app from the channel you trust.